Today, the piece that needs Carl's expertise is this American-designed 1920s bar top roulette machine. Fitting an old British penny, players would choose a color and gamble on the turn of the wheel. But it's been a very long time since this betting machine paid out.
It has to be so you can walk in, put it down, put your penny in it, pull the thing, twist that, and it works. If it doesn't do that, it's got no value.
In his workshop, Carl is taking a closer look. Even for an experienced antique restorer like him, this is a mammoth task. It's been decades since this roulette wheel has spun, with deep-set rust wreaking havoc on the many parts that are supposed to move.
Every single one of it has got to work precisely. Some are frozen, some aren't. Right, let's get it out. Get close inspection.
He's removing components to preserve their time-worn appearance, or patina, as they call it in the trade. This aged look is what makes the piece so attractive to collectors. Even the rudimentary repairs to the numbers by less skilled hands will remain, as it all adds to the story of the item's history. To free the mechanics so he can figure out how it all works, Carl is using a time-tested method, soaking the mass lump of rusted metal in a bath of diesel.
It sucks the diesel right into all the working parts, which then basically enables us to physically move them by lubrication. We don't want the rust removed, we want to keep the patina. If we were going for rust removal, we'd be going for an electrolysis method. But that's not what we want here. We're going for restoration, not rebuild.
For the past week, the rusted 1920s US roulette machine has been soaking in diesel. Engineer Carl is trying to free its frozen mechanism so he can finally start the vital repairs.
There's a lot of movement in the parts, which is brilliant. That's good, because it actually means that the diesel's worked. What I'm going to do now is work every single joint and keep working it until they're all free. So you've literally just got to spend hours and hours and hours working. Time, patience, time, patience, time, patience. I'm using a toothbrush to brush away some of the surface debris that's loose or semi-loose. Sometimes it's just enough to free up some of the parts, saving time.
Despite treating the metal to a bath and a brush, some of the parts remain stubbornly locked. Carl doesn't yet know whether Drew's gamble on getting this working again will pay off.
When you start a restoration, you always put pressure on yourself. You know what it's worth, you know what its potential value is. So you've always got the stress and worry of potentially wrecking a couple of £1,000 worth of profit.
Engineer Carl is still trying hard to salvage a 1920s US roulette machine.
It's ridiculously fiddly, and there isn't a built-in instruction manual.
When it first arrived in his workshop, the insides were locked solid. If Carl can't get the moving parts moving again, its value will drop drastically.
It's sort of suck it and see and try and work out how it goes together.
Each of the many thousand parts gets a thorough coating of white grease, a water and heat-resistant lubricant, which he's hoping will ease friction and add new life to the antique mechanism.
What I'm moving is the coin collector. That's better. Right, lay it back down. Springs.
The springs are critical to the mechanical controls, which detect what colour a player has placed their money on. If successful, this machine pays out from 2 to 20 coins in a single bet.
They go right from one side of the machine to the other. A tad awkward. All done.
Functioning properly for the first time in decades, Carl can finally rebuild.
I had severe reservations when I opened it up. Oh, no. But you didn't beat me, love. Round one to me.
This roulette machine was frozen in time, a bar top curio from a bygone age. Now, after 2 weeks' careful restorative work, its once rusted insides are ready to spin again. The oak cabinet with nickel-plated controls is polished up, and it's good for many more years of amusement.
The roulette machine's been pleasurable but equally painful. It's been a labour of love, but nice to see it finished.
So go on then, does it work? That's the main thing. How does it work?
Choose your colour, any slot, twist it clockwise, and then remember it's old school, so you've got to give it a good yank.
Oh, I've just won. Incredible. What a thing.
So, I've made a key for it as well.
Are we able to open the back?
Yep.
Wow. Look at that. Amazing. £250 is what this thing was worth. Now, this is worth about £1,500. Maybe a little bit more. Incredible.